Hello guys, Reaper here. Thanks for tuning in. Here to talk to you today about the Bellicose Interdictor. I have covered this ship in the past, quite some time ago when I first got it. I've managed to learn a few things about it. I think this ship is absolutely amazing. It really can go toe-to-toe with some of the pirate faction cruisers out there. It's a fraction of the cost, very, very versatile. And in this video, I really am going to show you how this ship can live up to its full potential and what it's capable of. So let's just start by refreshing people's memories on the attributes. For every level of advanced propulsion jamming per level, you'll have +5% to target painter effects, 5% bonus to target painter optimal range, and 5% bonus to warp disruption field effective range. And a really important one, for every level of advanced cruiser command, 5% bonus to missile torp velocity, 10% damage, and it can fit warp field generation modules. So looking at some of the headline stats, I've got 711 DPS with this fit. For my defense, cold, I've got 14,000 EHP, 4,400 shield, almost 4,000 armor, and 3,200 structure. My capacitor here shows 1 minute 39 seconds, which is incredibly low. However, I do have the capacitor battery, which boosts that up. Targeting 479 mm scan res, 77 meter sig radius, which is really, really good as well. For my navigation, 5 second align time and 381.86 meters per second, which means I'm around 1000 meters a second using my afterburner. And yeah, of course, the DPS is lovely. So for this particular build, you may want to go with rapids or medium missile launchers or torpedoes. That's completely up to you. I prefer to maximize my damage. However, a nice option would be to go with a couple of rapid launchers, a couple of torpedo launchers. This interdictor fit very much differs from my previous one because we have a large shield booster. So the power grid requirements can be quite extensive, but as you can see, with four of the rapid launchers fit, we are having almost 500 DPS, which is applying out well to 24 kilometers, hitting everything for full damage. So that's definitely an option. However, I very much prefer to use the torpedo launchers. And I think for the purpose of this video, I'm going to fit three torpedo launchers and I'll stick with one rapid launcher just to deal with some of the pesky frigates. My mid slots, I've gone with a web and a target painter, which is coming from the ship's racial bonus. Normally for the PvP, I'd have the warp field generation module instead of the web target painter, and I'd rely on my fleet mates webbing, scramming, and doing various other things. So again, this is really, really versatile. If I put on the warp generator, you'll see in the stats here, we've got a range of 21.88 kilometers. That's the singular direction. So the entire bubble's going to be from end to end, 44 kilometers in total. So quite a big bubble there for stopping ships. That requires fuel as well. And I've got a medium Nosferatu, which is one of the sub best metas. Republic fleet, target painter, which you can see 40% to the SIG radius with the ship skills, which is amazing. Mark 7 Valkyrie there. And in the low slots, here is the amazing thing. I've got a C-type large shield booster in place here, which is boosting almost three times what a medium would boost in a relatively similar amount of time, you know, a couple of seconds extra, but it's vast. I've got a couple of C-type adaptive invulnerability fields, medium afterburner, and a C-type medium cap battery. For the rigs, I've got two damage rigs. One of them's T3, one of them's T2. Couldn't quite afford all of them to be T3 in this particular case. And I've got the T3 bay loading accelerator for the activation time adjustment. For the engineering rigs, the power grid router T3, one cap control circuit, and I've got a cap amount rig T2. You could, with good skills, do away with the power grid router there, because my skills are 4-4 for my capacitor on cruisers. I am not cruiser specialized in any sense of the word. I am currently training Advanced Cruiser Command, which will give me an extra 10% bonus to my missile damage and also velocity for the range, which will be a significant amount of DPS with 711, which will look like 780 in the end. And then my other skills are fairly basic at best. I'm not specialist in cruisers in any way. For my engineering, I've got 4-4. So again, if I had my advanced engineering at 5, that's an extra 5% power grid. And if I had the expert skill trained up to 4, let's say, that's an extra 7. So that would be doing the 12% that I currently have invested in that rig. So if I could do away with that rig, fit in, let's say, 2 CCCs, Tech 2, and 1 Kappa mount rig, I may be able to extend my time for 2 minutes. Signal disruptions at 4 and 3. You'll see later on in the video that the capacitor time isn't factoring in for the activation of the battery, and you will be surprised how long I can run all of my modules for. I think in most, and my missile skills, by the way, are 5-5-4 and 5-5-3. Haven't really changed those since the last video. This is more about changing my low slots. On my previous fit, I had a ballistic control, I had a medium shield booster, so we've done away with the ballistic control. We've almost kept the DPS the same, and with some better skills, and we've got that shield booster. So this has great potential, and if you're small, fleeting, doing something like a gate camp, this will be able to take some serious punishment for a reasonable amount of time, but that's more burst damage. When you're in a gate camp, you tend to catch ships, and the fights don't go on for a very, very long amount of time. Certainly, I'll be able to shield boost for the whole length of most engagements, unless another huge fleet rocks up, in which case it doesn't matter how good your tank is. It's more of a numbers game. So right now, I've gone out into space. I'm here in Tama, and I'm on a 5 million-isk mission on the hard difficulty settings, just letting my shield drop low or low enough. I wanted to see how quickly I could pull the shield back, and also do another little test. I think I'll do that on the second wave when I get to, let's say, the last battleship, just to see how long I can run my modules for. Okay, so on normal speed now, let's see how long I can run all my modules for. We are going to activate everything. I against I, flesh in my flesh, in mine, in my mind. Two of a combo, one won't survive. My image is reflecting the enemy's eye, and his image is reflecting mine at the same time. I against I, flesh in my flesh, in mine, in my mind. Two of a combo, one won't survive. Right here's where the end gon' start at. Conflict, contact, combat. Fight a sin where the land is marked at. Settle the dispute about who the live is. Three word answer, whoever survived this. Only one of us could ride forever. So you and I can't ride together. Can't live or can't die together. All we could do is collide together. So I'll skillfully apply the pressure. Won't stop until I'm forever. One, a doorstep where death never come. Spread across time till my time never done. And I'm never done. Walk tall, why ever run? When they move, if I ever come. Bad man never fret the war. Tell them come, general, we are gonna start the march. Fire fun. I against die. Flesh in my flesh, in mine, in my mind. Two of a combo, one won't survive. My image is reflecting the enemy's eye, and his image is reflecting mine at the same time. I against die. Flesh in my flesh, in mine, in my mind. Two of a combo, one won't survive. Survive, 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 survive.
focus. No space regardless. You're on my path and get off it. Hard-headed and unresponsive. Get their lives put on target with harshness. Come with the cannon sparking, they darken. Who am I? One man squadron. Monster the fire. It's time to snatch it tomorrow. The 1,000-yard state it appears through your armor. You can get it all right now if you want to. But when your front line get marched through, I warned you. You know who forever belongs to.
In Eve time, that felt like an absolute eternity. So yeah, I think that this can be just pretty amazing in a small fleet. And even if you're doing some solo work, if you want to do some PvE, I plan to use this ship myself to do some easier storyline missions to save me hauling my Makari all over the place. And I very much enjoy this ship. I hope you guys do as well. If you've got any questions, please hit me up in the comments below. It would mean a great deal if you could like and subscribe. Trying to grow the channel. Thanks for watching. Your support is much appreciated. Cheers, guys.